My wife and I are in a small town in Switzerland called Beckenried, and check out this view from our hotel room. So you should definitely travel while you're saving for retirement, and here's why. But I'm gonna tell you why from just outside of Zermatt.
Sitting on the rail, super sketchy, four stories down. Hopefully this just stays right there. Freaks me out, but we're gonna go for it.
So there's two sides to the spectrum. Let's call one side the Dave Ramsey side and the other one the Grant Cardone side. Dave is trying to build the right character traits when it comes to finances. That's why he doesn't want you using credit cards. That's why he has you pay off your lowest debts to highest debts, regardless of interest rates. Because if you're on Dave Ramsey's baby steps, then you need some of these handicaps in place to help your mindset when it comes to financial management. Grant Cardone is leverage every penny of your net worth because you're getting rich off of other people's money. That's an exaggeration, but you get the idea. Most people, when talking about aggressive goals for retirement, would say, don't travel. That $6,000 vacation you just took is actually $80,000 invested over 30 years. And you threw it away because you wanted to go look at some mountains. And that idea is 100% correct. And if you are still in the stage where you need to develop your financial maturity, then you should not spend that money on a vacation. That would be like over here on the Dave Ramsey side. But do you know how many old people we've seen on this vacation? A ton. And the majority of them have trouble walking on simple pathways, or they're out of breath from the trip from the parking lot to the viewpoint. And yeah, some of that comes down to how you take care of your body, but most of that is unavoidable. You are going to get old and you are going to slow down. So, do you want that extra $80,000 in your bank account when you're 70 because you didn't go on that trip when you were 28? Or do you want to move along that spectrum to find a way to do both, travel and save for retirement? Here's the one sentence answer to that question. You need to figure out a way to make money while you travel. And this is a relatively new idea. Before the internet, you couldn't really do that. But in the 2 to 4 hours that I jump online and work every day, I will pay for this vacation and still have some left over. The problem is, as a real estate agent, it's not really sustainable. There's a part of my job that is in person based. It's very relationship based. If I'm not there in person, then the business kind of starts to fall apart. But I can go on vacation for 2 weeks and not have to worry about PTO or a boss or, you know, somebody who's making me feel like I need to be at work. Now there's other jobs like that. You could be a virtual assistant. You could work anywhere in the world that you want to and travel on the weekends. But the problem is you still aren't making money while you're traveling. You're not making money while you're on a gondola ride up to the top of the mountain. You need something that runs in the background, something that makes money while you sleep. Find that and you find early retirement. Creating and selling a product online, buying rental properties, social media, vending machines, car wash. Some of these are easier than others, but it's a start of a list of ideas to get you thinking about how can I make money while I'm on top of a mountain. If you haven't read The 4-Hour Workweek by Timothy Ferriss, it's worth a read. It's dense, there's a lot of details in it, a lot of business jargon, but he was able to build a passive income machine so he only had to work 4 hours per week. Brilliant. That's retirement right there. Man, it got dark real quick. But that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. I've been so encouraged by the growth of the channel. When I left for Europe, I had 200. Now I'm almost at 300. So if you liked the video, hit subscribe. I'd love to have you part of this channel. So hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will see you next time.